two things that forms these days of 21st, you know, century, and probably if you see the situation across the world, and majority of firms nowadays, in the last 10 years rather, they become more technology driven, right? I don't think that anyone of you are having apprehension on this, that majority of firms are either moving from brick and mortar business to digital businesses, or by default, they are from the digital background, right? So considering this as a fact, that this decade is to be called as the decade of technology, if you see from the perspective of companies, then majority of companies, including IBM, SAP, SAS, they generate Teradata, for example, Oracle, Microsoft, they're creating, you know, new organization units, which are primarily focused on analytics, which means that these firms, by default, those are, you know, technology-driven companies, which are helping their clients to structure their data, to help their client to create a competitive advantage by the usage of data. These companies, by the virtue of their, you know, establishment, by the virtue of their foundation, they are considered as the companies which are actually driven and drive technology on behalf of clients, and they actually they create a lot of data lakes, and they work on that. So these companies are primarily considered as the pioneer companies in the area of data and its utilization, data-driven firms, I must say. And through these companies, their clients are using analytics and help their businesses to become more effective and efficient, right? So particularly in their operations, operation means day-to-day activities particularly. So nowadays, companies and the clients, the companies I was talking about, their clients themselves become more, you know, data-driven, and majority of businesses which are being drawn by these companies are actually emphasizing more on, you know, decision based on data. Beside, I wish to take you to one more, you know, perspective that is called customers. Nowadays, customers are also using data in a direct or indirect form, which are their routine, you know, activities they're doing, and they come out with a decision based on that. And these routine activities are primarily shopping, you know, healthcare, health-related issues, traveling, entertainment. And virtually, we through different applications or apps, mobile apps, we are using data. And we are using data analytics particularly. So that's how data analytics become a kind of, you know, common term or something which is at center, which is being deployed and used and exploited by the companies and the customers. We can understand that data is driving the whole industries, right? They're creating a balance between the customers and the companies, right? So this is something in between we have. And we can see that particularly virtually in every industry, for example, healthcare, sports, travels, entertainment, supply chain utilities, all these companies, all these industries are using data for their day-to-day or operational businesses, which means that how we can understand data as a becoming a backbone actually for the companies. Now, when it comes to understanding the management perspective or managerial perspective of data and utilization, let me differentiate data into three forms of utilizations. First is descriptive analytics. Analytics means data analysis, actually. So first form is descriptive, second is predictive, third is prescriptive. As we all understand, descriptive is basically, it focuses more on, you know, nature of data, which means what happened, you know, through the understanding of about how data works on something which happened and how different statistical, you know, modeling can help us to understand that situation. It can be understood through different visualization diagrams. Recently, I've shown two dashboard diagrams to you using Python and Google Data Studio. So that was one of the descriptive analytics because it was based on the past data, right? And it can help the firm to make itself different from its competitor. And through a data analytics for a business intelligence perspective, we can use descriptive analytics, right? So one form of data analysis is, or data analytics is, descriptive analytics, which can be helpful for manager to take decisions on routine basis. Second form could be prescriptive, right? Predictive, let me take it in order. Predictive analytics is basically, by and large, we can understand through data mining, right? Text and web mining, social media mining. So you want to actually, let me take an example. You want to understand as a company or as a website that how my website should look. So based on the past runs, based on the past trends, where you do the data mining, you understand that what products the customers are preferring. Because you have a little space when it comes to the website. And within that little space, you have to, showcase your products. For instance, Amazon particularly want to understand where to put what product. So when Devi Prasad Samwal will log in, he will see the product as per his, understanding, as per his viewpoint. So the website can be further customized from the viewpoint of a particular user. Similarly, when Ravina logged in, she must have, a different viewpoint as per her desires. So based on the past, mining, the firm can, create, Amazon kind of company can create variety of personalized solution to the customers, which can happen only through data mining or web mining and social media mining. They can also link it with your social media, Instagram account, Facebook account. So firms are actually becoming more, personalized in terms of their presentation to the customers, right? So predictive analytics is more about, using data intelligently, and it is coming through a lot of other resources, not only from the website primarily, which Amazon is doing or any company is doing in order to cater the need or, potential product purchase by Devi Prasad Uniyal or Samwal or Ravina Sharma. Similarly, prescriptive analytics is by and large can understand through optimization and simulation. I will let you know about all this. But importantly, the exciting point is in the field of business intelligence and business analytics, which is rapidly, evolving. There's something, new, and new and new technologies are coming up. We are using, different form of interfaces. We are using different technologies on the backside, on the right. And a lot of innovation is happening in terms of presentation, in terms of data extraction, in terms of, data streaming. So as a student of business analytics, we have to also understand the things from the viewpoint of not only from managerial decision making, but also need to understand which technology is behind it, right? So a good balance is required. So you are the part of a journey where you have to undergo a lot of inputs from different resources. Python could be a great help in that case because Python will not only give you a kind of understanding about how computation out computerized technologies or how this particular coding language can help you to showcase yourself as a product marketer to the customers, but also help you from the viewpoint of a firm to make good decisions. We need to understand that firstly, we need to understand before getting into Python or on to be a kind of new things for most of you because it's a mixed batch I'm taking care of right now is the extra class. So I'm seeing that students of regular MBA has also come. And we have people from industry also. Those are happen to our EMBA students. So we need to understand first, initially, if you want to really learn about Python, because Python is not a capsule that you simply, take with the breakfast And by the evening, you will energize with all the sides of Python. It's a gradual process, actually. So let me start with understanding the need of computerization support system for making decisions in an organization, right? I will try to brief you about that. And one interesting thing is during this understanding that how computerization is supporting management decision, we also need to understand that how in our day-to-day managerial decisions, operational decisions particularly, how computerized support is becoming more prominent. Why companies are requiring more computerization in taking day-to-day decisions, right? Besides, I wish to also tell you about the term called business intelligence and how it work. What is the methodology? In simple sense, business intelligence is more about how intelligently you can use resources over your competitors, so you will maintain your competitive advantage in simple layman language, right? And we also might try to ponder upon different form of analytics. As I've said, there are three forms primarily, and we have two or three other forms also, which are basically a sub-classification among these three forms. And I wish to also tell you about the
You told us about four forms. One of them is diagnostic analytics.
One could be a diagnostic analytics. Yes, true. And we have lot many other also. I will let you know about them gradually. One thing which actually really excites us is the usage of computerization, right? And as we've seen that the business environment or the climate is now constantly changing, right? Not from now situation, but also in the earlier time, during the time when the firms were required to have, integration with their suppliers, they have to create an information system so that they can easily, communicate with the exchange of data. And here comes, inter-organizational information systems come into picture. Then firm decided upon they will create this information system more secured, and they created ERPs, right? And the rest is the story. So gradually things become more complex because more and more people are coming up, jumping into the ecosystem. And the firm is not only responsible to take care of the requirement of the customers. They require to have more, cohesiveness with their suppliers. So there is a kind of, ecosystem become more complex in terms of the number of parties we are engaging in order to, producing a product or putting that product to the market. So if you see on the supply side, let me make it more, clear, more simplified form, that if you see from the viewpoint of the suppliers, on the supply side particularly, you can simply assume that a company which is manufacturing a product for you, for instance, a car manufacturer, is not actually responsible solely, it's not solely responsible to make the car. He required to have a kind of, that company required to have a kind of good understanding between its suppliers also. For example, Maruti Udyog Limited or Suzuki Maruti Limited, SML, is to produce, a vehicle, Alto 800, for instance. So it's a resultant of every single stock keeping unit or simple unit of SML Alto 800, Maruti Alto 800, is a resultant of the efforts that Maruti or SML is putting in order to create a network of understanding so that they can exchange information with themselves as a factory, and also or assembling point, and also with variety of suppliers. They have to have great, real-time relationship with their tire manufacturing vendors. They have to have this real-time understanding or information exchange with their engine suppliers. They have to create a real-time, understanding and exchange of information with the glass manufacturing company or glass supplier to them. Same goes with chassis, same goes with, aluminum sheets, same goes with, braking system, bore for example. So they have to create a system where all these companies, considering suppose 200 firms are engaged into supply of small and big components, automobile, small and big components to this company SML. So we have to create a network, we have to create an information system which can cater 201 entities at a place, right? And there must be little room for any form of error. There must be no mismatch between what SML is requiring, Suzuki Maruti Limited is requiring, and how the suppliers are understanding and perceive that requirement. So it has only happened because, unfortunately, suppliers are not living in the same physical ecosystem that SML is into. It's not possible for the suppliers to establish their plant inside the plant of or factory layout of SML. Physically, they are distance apart. So we have to create an information system which can, help them to work in transparency. They have to work in kind of great coordination, and there will be little or no room for any misunderstanding. Right? So now, importantly, as I wanted to end it, tell you about, that they have to create an information system, which is better known as ERP, Enterprise Resource Planning, so that SML can create an ecosystem in every party which is engaged into supply of small and big components to SML will be the part of that ERP system. So now, importantly, such activities which SML as an organization is doing it in the kind of cohesiveness with other suppliers. So the system gradually become more agile, more so-called vibrant, dynamic, and quick in terms of response to the market. So when customer wants n number of SKUs or Maruti 800 Alto, suppose the dealer here, the customer is a dealer actually. The dealer wants 200% increase in the sales. In that case, Maruti can response to that new enhanced demand, and it can only happen when they have a real time dialogue, when they have real time information exchange with their suppliers. So you need to understand this flow of information, so that every action which is happening as an operation on day-to-day basis will remain free from any form of flaw or error or any kind of misunderstanding in layman form, layman language. So here comes data exchange, that whatever data is coming from the dealer in terms of increase in demand can be passed on to the suppliers also. So Maruti Udyog Limited or Suzuki Maruti Limited, as formerly it was known as Maruti Udyog Limited, has to create an ecosystem where not only the supplier at the part, but also the customers, the dealers, the wholesalers. Although we understand the mechanism of how cars are being manufactured and distributed to the customers. So we have to create a system where the customers, producer, assembler, I mean to say, and the suppliers are becoming the part of the common ecosystem. And every day, new and new dealers are coming up and join this. Every day, new and new suppliers will come. So it must have the scalability also. Scalability is a property of a system where you have a kind of possibility to add more members. So this is something we need to understand. Unfortunately, while we have lecturing in this subject, we will try to have more understanding through exposure on different firms, through case studies, through both conceptual case studies and theoretical case studies, and also the numerical understanding about how the firms has actually created the so-called usage of data analytics for making the firm more sustainable and performance-wise more agile. And we will also try to experience it through some sort of software also. And we'll try to explore more possibility of how we work as a team while we have different small games, or I must say different small situation, business situation, where I will ask you people to work in a team, and you will gradually understand the meaning and the sense sort of how the firms can create a ecosystem for with the usage of business analytics or data analytics for making routine and good decisions. So the flow is like business analytics is required, and it is being supported by a computerized information system, which is by default is with every company. So the prerequisite for deploying business analytics is the system must be at place. It should be computerized. It should use and make sense of data. That's how, like a system which required a good understanding about computerizing technology. They must use information system. They must have information system in place so that they can use better the analytical techniques. And the people in the organization, like you people in future, should have the clear-cut understanding about how variety of theories and the concepts, which are more of managerial in nature, can be deployed for making decision in the concerned with or in the usage with variety of commercial tools and techniques, which are primarily of computerization techniques, which can help you to take better decision as an organization. So this is the whole structure of what we have to do and understand and prerequisitely need to have. Now, the other aspect of discussion today is which is very exciting and directly coming through the usage of Python, which for which we are assembled here. And this is something, we have to understand that there's something called ML, machine learning, because see, Python is obviously is useful, of course, but you need to utilize Python for a specific, purpose, right? So I wish to tell you about a brief on how machine learning can help you to solve the real-time problems, how machine learning, framework can build upon Python as a language. So let me rush to the things gradually. And wish to tell you about something called as artificial intelligence first, right? Because we must need to know the reason why Python is here, right? So it's not a compulsory class. I mean, if you're not comfortable with the usage of Python, you can leave it here and move ahead with your theoretical stuff. Nobody's insisting you to learn Python, right? Let me have a disclaimer of this. And but the best part with Python is it doesn't require any kind of programming background. The best part with Python is it will help you to make good decisions, right? It's a need of our everybody's interested to use Python. And the future employers are also looking forward for the people with this sort of skill set. They want people from not from the technical background, but the people which who can sense and use Python sort of language for making great decision when it comes to data analytics. So it's up to you how you perceive, right? Considering all the constraints at our side, considering all the mental constraints at your side, right? I'm not insisting anybody to learn it or live it. So it's up to you, entirely up to you. It's simply an extra class that is meant to make you more, familiar with the term Python and the background stories. So here comes something, we need to, why we required analytics and how analytics could be, because we have two things to understand. First is, the theory, the usage, the application that industry does this, they required, technology for making good decisions, right? This is something, anybody can understand. I mean, there is no requirement to have MBA program for that. Everybody can make sense that even a plus two guy who is working with the industry, who's a peon with Infosys or any IBM or SAS kind of company, he can make simply understanding that we're required to have, these sort of things because we want to be, more updated. We need to have take decisions every time. That's why it is important. And the second aspect is how we can utilize and become the part of this new, era where if we learn it, if we can use it, we can create, more value addition to our clients, customers, right? And we become a kind of, our nation become more cash cow in that sense, and make more, dollars. And as a part of the company, our role will be more prominent. So it's up to you which portion you would like to have, right? I'm not insisting anyway. I can understand your engagements also, but this is my humble duty to let you know anything which is coming on the way, which is latest, which has some relevance, which can be useful for you, right? So I'm just, I'm doing my duty, and entirely it's up to you. Don't feel any kind of psychological pressure when it comes to, reading and developing yourself in terms of this language. So let us get back to something very interesting that is called as artificial intelligence, right? So anybody out of you, Pankaj based, do you understand what is artificial intelligence?
Yes, sir. So, sir, artificial intelligence is, when we gather the data and we do some coding so that we can understand the behavior of a user, and we give a prediction about something.
Okay, can you make it more simplified? I mean, suppose I'm very new to the thing. I wish to understand how artificial intelligence can be fruitful for me as a layman. Are you seeing it something, relevant for somebody who doesn't found programming interesting? So how we can, understand the term artificial intelligence? Any more example you have?
Let's suppose, sir,
Yeah.
I'm using a YouTube, and when I search for a few of the videos or searches, it gives me a predictive analysis, or it gives me a suggestion to some of the videos in my past searches based on the past searches. That is kind of AI.
Great. So it could be an application of AI, right? It is one among them. It's not the direct use of AI, but it is coming through DL actually. I will talk about it. Right, correct. Rashi, can you make sense that AI is something is with us nowadays? And if yes, how AI is useful for anybody, I mean, like you and me as a customer, or maybe for a company. Do you have any example to understand this? Or do you understand what AI is for you? Rashi, you there?
Yes, sir. So AI is a demonstration made by machine.
Correct, good. What kind of demonstration? Sorry. What is that demonstration all about? Yeah, Shagun, would you like to say something?
Yes, like AI is a simulation of human intelligence in machines, like that are programmed to think like humans, and like their action should be, controlled by humans.
All right, so let me take a small, example. Gary Kasparov he was a famous, world champion. Famous in terms because he was able to, able to win the world championship from so successively for the 5 6 years. And Vishwanathan Anand, he is actually Indian chess master. And Garry Kasparov has defeated Vishwanathan Anand and become the world champion. It was a story. It was around the time of 1999 or 2000, and gradually afterwards, for the next 4 5 years, he was able to maintain that position as a world champion. So now, IBM challenged Garry Kasparov, who was a world chess champion, to play a match with IBM's innovation, which was a human-like intelligence-based computer, and they call it Deep Blue. So that Deep Blue was basically a computing machine. It was a computer, roughly, which can, you know, which was programmed to think like human being. And as you know, that chess is a game of mind. So during the time when they decided, Gary Kasparov accepted the challenge and they set for a kind of, you know, competition where Gary Kasparov was defeated by Deep Blue in a straight, you know, match. And it was first defeat of human, first, you know, success, I must say, first, you know, success of AI-based, human-like, intelligence-based computer over human. Although Garry Kasparov, next year, he challenged Deep Blue again and he won it. And as we understand that chess is a game of permutation and combination, where we have to not only think from the viewpoint of what we have to act, but also need to think that what counter-attack can our opponent can do. So chess is a game of strategies also. So this story, why I'm telling this, because this was the first attempt by a big company, Deep Blue. IBM is called as Deep Blue also. That's why they come out with this concept. And this was become a kind of history that computers will replace the race. And people were, you know, more, you know, worried about, since that time, people were worried about, you know, that human race will be replaced by computers. And this is true also. But what I wanted to tell across through this story is the system, that computer, which is Deep Blue, it exhibits the human-like intelligence, like Shogun was telling us, or Rashi has said, that this kind of system will think as human can think, right? Or maybe more, you know, more powered, more, you know, faster than the human thinking. So, machine which is think like a system as a human being, which can create some sort of permutation or combination. Yeah, Anuradha ji, bataiye. Yes, yes.
Sir, like Google Maps ho gaye, wo aapko pehle se hi bata dete hain ki aage ka route ho gaya, then parking your car and all. Aajkal
yes.
Hai.
Yes,
these
yes.
are all artificial intelligence, like Lenskart is using artificial intelligence and all.
Correct, correct. So they are the revived form of artificial intelligence, but it starts with, you know, understanding the human mind. How we can, this is Deep Blue. Deep Blue is an example where, you know, IBM developed it as a human-like thinking. So the example that Anuradha ji was telling is, or somebody else like Subhash, or I guess Pankaj has said, these examples are more applications which are on the customer side, like, and they are more towards, you know, revived form of this basic understanding that a computer need to think like human. Like Ravina said in Terminator movie, we developed a robot which was thinking, having some sort of, you know, emotional intelligence also, which has human sentiments as well. And so they have cutting edge over the human being. So gradually, a lot of applications has come up. So now let me create a kind of, you know, understanding about how machine learning. Yeah, there are a lot of examples, Devi Prasad ji. China or anyone is using artificial intelligence these days, right? So the trials which were happening about COVID-19, you know, vaccines, are not being done on human race now.
That AI is nothing but just robot.
It's about what, Shagun?
Sir, like aap bol rahe ho, ye bas robots hote hain, AI.
No, no, it's not so. This is something I wish to tell you. It's not about robots. This is something, you know, we created. Obviously, robot is one of the form which is directly visible to us.
Sir, जैसे signals होते हैं, sir, जैसे signals में होते हैं, red light, blue light, you know, they scan the this thing कि आपने red light cross किया है, तो आपको automatically
चलान कट जाएगा. इन इन फॉरेन कंट्रीज इट्स लाइक दैट, एंड नाउ इट्स इवन इन इंडिया, इट्स इंडिया इज ऑल्सो डेवलप्ड. दिस इज ऑल एआई.
Their AI-based application. She's right. So now that means AI is more than robots, right? AI is more than robots, and AI is not constraint wise. AI is not AI की progressive deep blue तक नहीं थी. इसके आगे भी AI बढ़ा है. जैसे अभी कई examples आपको देखने को मिले. अनुराधा जी से ट्रैफिक स्मार्ट ट्रैफिकिंग के लिए, ट्रैफिक मैनेजमेंट के लिए हम लोग AI यूज कर सकते हैं. वी कैन यूज AI फॉर सर्चिंग इन यूट्यूब. इट इज ऑलरेडी देयर. देवी प्रसाद जी सेड दैट AI इज बीइंग यूज्ड फॉर मेडिसिनल ट्रायल्स आल्सो. सो वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट AI हैज लॉट ऑफ सबसेट्स, एंड वन ऑफ द सबसेट विद इन AI इज कॉल्ड एज मशीन लर्निंग, विच इज अ सबसेट ऑफ AI, एंड विच इज बेसिकली इज अ काइंड ऑफ A process is an algorithm, actually is a computerized procedure which can learn a particular task, how it perform, and which creates a model based on the data. So basically machine learning, you can understand that machine learning is a subset of AI, and it can simply programmed in such a way it can understand and sense what task to be performed, and how it can use data for performing that task. We have third component of AI, which is called as machine. This is called as deep learning, which is again the subset of machine learning, which can help us to understand how human brain can solve a problem. Like, let me take an example of Anuradha ji. If you ask somebody to help you to understand the route to go to Ramnagar, for example, from Dehradun, so what could be the possible way for doing this? So if you ask Priyanka Bhandari that, Priyanka, I wish to go to Ramnagar from Dehradun, what could be the possible way? Priyanka may have three or four answers to your question, three or four alternatives to your question. One route could be go to Delhi, then go to place two. Then you can, from place two, you can go to Ramnagar. Second way is go to Haridwar, take the route from Chandi Pul, Chandi Bridge, Chandi Devi Bridge, and via Nazimabad, via Muradabad, via Kumaon, you can go to Ramnagar. Third solution could be you simply go to Chandi Pul, Chandi Devi Pul, Chandi Devi Bridge. You can take a route to Nazimabad. Then you escape the whole, portion between. You can take a bypass journey. You can through villages. You can go to Ramnagar. So there could be n number of ways that she can help you to understand to reach to Ramnagar as such. So now, importantly, how machine or how artificial intelligence can help you? They have, they understood all these three, four possible routes, right? But they can help you to understand where you can save your time, right? Where you can save your energy, where you can save your fuel. So Google Map, I'm taking an example of Anuradha ji, can help you to understand the possible way to reach at minimum time, at minimum fuel, optimum time and optimum fuel to a place from Dehradun, for example, to Ramnagar. So this could be a kind of application where that software, which is Google Map, will think like a human being, which can help you a possible solution for any point of start to point of termination, which is Ramnagar, point of start is Dehradun, and the possible ways to reach to that level. So it is similarly, if you ask Priyanka, she can tell you the three routes. Similarly, Google can tell you the three or four routes, and you can reach to the possible destination, that is Ramnagar, through opting either of these routes. Even if you missed a route and you got a little deviation, or you misunderstand the sign, then also Google or that any software which is of mapping purpose will help you to understand the alternative way. Suppose Anuradha ji missed one turn, so Google Map will again tell you the proper way to go it. You take U-turn, go for 200 meters ahead, and you can take further turn to the main route, which was initially programmed and understand by Google Map. It was happened, no? Anuradha ji, aisa hota hai na? It happened, is it?
यस सर, रीराउटिंग बताती है.
हाँ, तो द इम्पोर्टेंट थिंग इज इट्स लाइक एनी ह्यूमन बींग. अगर आप मिस कर जाते हो, प्रियंका को रास्ता पता है, तो प्रियंका को बताएगी, अरे मैडम आपने रास्ता छोड़ दिया, कोई बात नहीं, आगे से आप टर्न कर सकते हो. द सेम लाइक अ ह्यूमन थिंग, राइट? सो दैट्स वाई द एप्लीकेशन गूगल मैप, इट इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज द डीप लर्निंग एप्लीकेशन, विच वॉज एक्चुअली बिल्ड ऑन AI, बिकॉज एज वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट डीप लर्निंग इज अ सबसेट ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस. So any software who can think as human become the part of AI, right? Is that okay? I think we can make sense. Like Devi Prasad ji's example was same. Human trial क्यों किए जाते हैं? Human trial इसलिए किए जाते हैं कि आप किसी drug की recipients as a human body, how you react on some infusion of any drug on your body. आप कैसे रिएक्ट करते हो, कैसे एंटीबॉडीज जनरेट होती हैं, ये आप समझना चाहते हो. तो दैट्स व्हाई ह्यूमन ट्रायल किए जाते हैं. तो इंस्टेड ऑफ अंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट COVID-19 वैक्सीन इज वेरी इनिशियल स्टेज, राइट, लेट मी अंडरस्टैंड इट फ्रॉम द व्यू पॉइंट दैट वी आर डूइंग COVID-19 वैक्सीन सो कॉल्ड ट्रायल्स, नॉट ओनली इन द ह्यूमन बॉडी, इन ऑर्डर टू रिड्यूस एनी पॉइंट ऑफ साइड इफेक्ट्स ऑन एनी फॉर्म ऑफ negative effect on our body. We can have the trials on not human body on we can have the trials on the computers or the robots or maybe alike things. So in that case, the possibility of getting response as a human body in terms of creating antibodies or creating some sort of allergy within the body, robot can tell you. So it will save possibility of any form of risk on the human body, because all these risks are being replaced when it comes to replacing human being with the machine, and that machine can give you the same response or same statistics that a human body can give. Devi Prasad ji, main sahi bol raha hoon?
Yes, sir.
So that's fine. Similarly, coming to Anuradha ji's point that nowadays shopping, we have lot of applications of AI. So while during the COVID time, you can inspect and go to nearby eye care center, because while seeing OTTs and programs on Amazon Prime, Netflix, आपकी आंखों में स्ट्रेन आया और आपको अब डाउट है कि आपकी आई साइट बढ़ गई है, पर आप जा नहीं सकते हो, COVID-19 की वजह से लॉकडाउन है. तो ऐसे में वाइल सिटिंग एट अ प्लेस, यू कैन गो टू द वेबसाइट ऑफ लेंसकार्ट एंड यू कैन सिंपली हैव इंस्पेक्शन ऑन व्हाट कुड बी द पॉसिबल नेक्स्ट परचेज ऑफ द फ्रेम और द आई ग्लास विदाउट गोइंग टू द फिजिकल आई क्लिनिक. यू कैन ऑप्ट फॉर द बेस्ट फिट आई ग्लासेस, आई फ्रेम or your eyes, and also Flipkart can help you, right, through augmented reality, which is one of the form of AI. What could be the possible frame fit to your face, right, after taking the aesthetics of your face, after taking dimension from your face and setting the coordinate on your face, right? It can help you to understand what could be the possible frame, and also suggest you if your eyesight is get increased. They can also do iris scanning of your eyes and can help you to understand what could be the increased, number of your left and right eye. So it's a complete solution, eye care solution by using AI by Flipkart, by Lenskart to you without, going to any physical, store. It can happen online. Similarly, you may have the online shopping experience. Ravina is interested to purchase something from Amazon. Amazon is interested to know that how they can sell more to Ravina. So based on her past search, they can give her the possible, preference shopping catalog. So based on that preferred shopping catalog, Ravina can, and these all possible goods that are in her kitty are basically based on the preference she showed in the last searches. So this kind of human understanding, understanding the behavior of the human being, firms like Amazon, Flipkart, sorry, this iClinic website, Lenskart, or maybe high-end this clinical trial organization like Serum India, or maybe Oxford or any Johnson & Johnson kind of company, without, you know, using human being, human-like presence, they can exploit and go for the more and more trials. So if you see across 360 degree, you can understand that every sphere of life is being, you know, used, can, or it can be deployed through a lot of applications of AI, DL, and ML. So, but what I've said is AI has two components. One is called as machine learning, which is a subset of AI. And machine learning has one subcomponent, which is called as deep learning. So deep learning is becoming a part of, you know, machine learning, and definitely it become the subset of AI. AI thus,
so video games ho gaye. Video games ho gaye. Jaise hum launch.
Yeah, Snapchat ab khelte ho. Snapchat mein aap photograph lete ho apni. You know, Shagun and Rashi do it frequently. You have a lot of funny faces on Snapchat. So that funny faces, which is basically coming up all the way, which is not a part of your, you know, basic so-called natural face, it is coming as a top-in. Snapchat use kiya, Rashi and Shagun, have you used it? I'm saying two,
yes,
girls,
sir.
Here too. So you did a lot of experiments with your faces, and they have predefined programs which fit into your face. They set the coordinates, and based on that, yeah, digital, you know, digital objects are being fixed on your face. And strangely, Snapchat हर फेस पे काम करता है. ऐसा नहीं है कि उनके
एक ऐप ये भी तो आया था जिसमें कि हाउ यू विल लुक इन कमिंग 30 इयर्स 40 इयर्स.
एग्जैक्टली. सो फेस व्हाट यू कॉल इट दिस काइंड ऑफ ऐप इज बेसिकली इट्स फेस व्हाट
फेस रिकॉग्निशन.
नो दे डू द फेस रिकॉग्निशन फेस रीडर्स एंड ऑल आई विल नेम इट बाय एनी नेम बट बाय एंड लार्ज दिस काइंड ऑफ एप्स आर नथिंग बट द यूसेज ऑफ machine learning and deep learning, which are completely based on the AI-based algorithms. So you have every reason to connect your customer and give them all possible ways to entertain them, right? And they could be, you know, great help for the company to, you know, earn more and more revenue by giving the possible solutions to the daily needs or daily entertainment needs of the customers, right? So AI make a great sense to the consumerism customer marketplace. Now when it comes to machine learning, I'm particularly focusing on machine learning because machine learning is something, you know, has a direct application of Python. So it has two components, right? Ab ye baat samajh mein aa gayi ki AI ke do components hai. Ye to clear ho gaya aap logo ko. Aap log ko jante hain already. Is it Ravina, are you getting the point? I hope that it is not troubling you. Are you able to make sense of the discussion we are having today? Yes or no? Anyways, let me move ahead now. Now, importantly, machine learning. When you call something as learning, anybody? When you call something as learning. Okay.
When it teaches you the steps, how to do it.
Come again, analogy. I have not been able to hear. What you said?
When it teaches you the steps how to do it.
Okay, okay.
Acquiring knowledge of something.
So
acquiring knowledge.
We need training to, you know.
Hmm. Mm-hmm.
We need training to, you know, make them work.
Okay. Don't you think the learning is reviving your old form? Okay, let me take an example. Suppose I ask Anuradha ji, what is your skill level when it comes to car driving? whether it is entry, I mean, there are three level. One is called expert level, second is called as medium, and the basic is amateur. Which level of car you drive, Anuradha ji?
Medium.
Medium. So she said that I'm not a great expert into car driving. I drive carefully, and I maintain a speed of 40 or 30, whatever she find as an average speed. And she call herself as a medium category of driver. So she drives safely. I mean, in a six lane, even if she got a blank road, she also, you know, even that situation, she follow a speed, an average speed of 30 or 40 kilometer per hour. So she don't get, you know, स्पीड है बिकॉज कंट्रोल खराब हो जाते हैं और ये सब चीजें, तो कंट्रोल नहीं रह पाते हैं। इस वजह से अनुराधा जी का कहना है कि वो मीडियम है। सुभाष जी, वेयर यू कंसिडर योर सेल्फ, आर यू एक्सपर्ट मीडियम और यू आर एमेच्योर ड्राइवर कार
हाँ सर,
ड्राइविंग?
मीडियम मीडियम
मीडियम,
आई ड्राइव से।
मीडियम। देवीलाल जी, देवी प्रसाद जी,
सर मीडियम।
मीडियम, ओके गुड। राशि, कार को स्कूटर से रिप्लेस कर दो इफ यू डोंट ड्राइव कार। यस, मीडियम। कोई यहाँ पे एडवेंचर फॉर्मूला वन नहीं है क्या? शरद शर्मा जी,
सर
वेयर यू थिंक यू आर?
I can't say I am an expert, but I have drove a lot also to different roads and locations. तो मैं ये नहीं कह सकता कि I am an expert. Formula One तो नहीं कह सकता, but हाँ, to an extent I have drove a lot. हाँ.
Okay, so he improved. This is something I want to hear actually. So gradually, if you call yourself an expert or as a mediator, mediocre, you actually learn from a base, right? Gradually you learn, right? And this improvement is continuous. Even if you talk to Formula One drivers, they will say that gradually they learn how to drive, how to anticipate, you know, possible dangers, where at what, you know, at what angle they have to take turn, right? So a lot of things actually an expert required to have, and gradually it learn. So if machine learn from its past, you know, so-called analysis, and the new analysis is the extended or additional, you know, or more improvised form, that is called as learning. So learning here means the same as we are having it as a human being, that we are becoming more focused, more error-free, more accurate, more faster, right? And gradually we become more learned, right? Like for example, let me take another layman example that we start making sentences, right? So we are not born English. So in order to make sentence, we need to learn words, right? And we combine words, we put some sort of, you know, grammar into it, and we create the sentence. So just remember when during your childhood days, when you make wrong sentences and your teacher penalize you or your parents ask you to correct it. And gradually over the period of time, based on your experience and exposure, you become a proficient English writer or an orator. So it happened gradually. It is not happening, you know, instant or radically. It happened a gradual. It is a process which is a gradual learning. So learning, any form of learning is gradual, right? You improve your level, you become more accurate, you become, you know, more than what you were earlier. That's why it is called learning. So यहाँ learning का मतलब है कि machine, यानी कि जो प्रोग्राम किया आपने, राइट, जो आपने एल्गोरिथम्स बनाई हैं, उनकी कैपेबिलिटी, राइट, पुराने वाले वर्जन से इम्प्रूव रहती है, राइट? आप किसी भी एग्जांपल को ले लीजिए। पहले गूगल मैप अगर आप यूज़ करते थे आज से 10 साल पहले, तो गूगल कंफ्यूज भी करता था आपको, स्टिल अभी भी कंफ्यूज करता है, जो रास्ते अननोन हैं, जो ऑलरेडी कोऑर्डिनेट सेट नहीं है जिनके, स्पेशली ऐसे रास्ते जहाँ लोग कम ट्रेवल करते हैं, वहाँ पे कई बार आपको मिसलीड भी करता है गूगल। एंड ग्रेजुअली इफ यू पुट अ फीडबैक, बिकॉज ये सारे सॉफ्टवेयर बीटा हैं, बीटा वर्जन्स हैं, इफ यू पुट अ फीडबैक दैट यू 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 गिव अ रॉन्ग यू नो डायरेक्शन, अगर उनके स्टार्स आप कम देते हैं तो वो इम्प्रोवनाइज करते हैं इसमें। सो मशीन लर्निंग का मतलब भी ये है कि जो ऐसे इंटरफेस लाइक गूगल मैप, दे बिकम मोर यू नो इम्प्रूव्ड बेस्ड ऑन द पास्ट एरर्स दे हैव मेड, एंड दिस प्रोसेस इज ग्रेजुअल बिकॉज लॉट ऑफ डेवलपर्स ऑन द बैक एंड दे आर वर्किंग राइट। सो एवरी न्यू फॉर्म इज इम्प्रोवनाइज्ड। अरे गैरी कास्परोव अगर मैच जीत भी जाते हैं, देयर इज ऑलवेज अ चांस कि नेक्स्ट टाइम वो हार जाते हैं मैच, बिकॉज जो डेवलपर्स थे डीप ब्लू के IBM, वो उसकी उसकी कॉम्बिनेशन या परम्यूटेशन को और स्ट्रॉन्ग कर देते हैं एल्गोरिथम वाइज। सो वी हैव ह्यूमन बीइंग बिहाइंड, नो डाउट्स दैट द डेवलपर्स हु मेक द सॉफ्टवेयर्स और एनी काइंड ऑफ मशीन इंटरफेस, दे आर द पीपल ओनली, एंड एवरी वर्जन ऑफ यू नो टर्मिनेटर लाइक रवीना सेट बिकम मोर डेंजरस एंड मोर यू नो थिंक लाइक ह्यूमन बींग, एंड सिमिलरली मशीन्स बिकम मोर यू नो स्मार्टर देन देयर प्रीवियस वर्जन। दैट्स व्हाई द लर्निंग थिंग कम। मशीन लर्निंग मीन्स इंटरफेस, मशीन इज मशीन लर्निंग में मशीन वाला पर्सपेक्टिव क्या है कि द काइंड ऑफ यू नो इंटरफेस दे हैव डेवलप्ड बिकम मोर यू नो पावरफुल इन टर्म्स ऑफ कैलकुलेशंस देन द पास्ट वर्जन राइट, एंड इट कैन हेल्प यू नो यूजर्स लाइक मी एंड यू टू ट्रैक डाउन लॉट ऑफ एरर्स दैट वी डन मैनुअली विद द यूजेज ऑफ दीज यू नो सॉफ्टवेयर्स, दीज काइंड ऑफ एप्स। सो एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग कुड बी ऑल द पॉसिबल फॉर्म्स वेर द एक्यूरेसी इज रिक्वायर्ड, फॉर एग्जाम्पल बैंक फ्रॉड रोकने हैं, तो बैंकिंग फ्रॉड्स रोकने के लिए अब वेबसाइट्स भी मशीन लर्निंग बेस्ड हैं, दे कैन अंडरस्टैंड कि सम हैकर्स कैन और मशीन और सम मशीन जनरेटेड एल्गोरिथम्स और अटेम्प्ट्स कैन बी हैपन्ड ऑन द वेबसाइट ऑफ अ बैंक। सो आपसे जब आप वेबसाइट में एंटर करते हो तो आपसे वो सिर्फ आपका लॉगिन पासवर्ड नहीं पूछता, आपसे कैप्चा भी पूछता है। कैप्चा यू अंडरस्टैंड नो, आपको पैटर्न्स राइट करने पड़ते हैं शरद जी। यस या एवरीबॉडी एवरीबॉडी कैन अंडरस्टैंड। यस तो ये देखना चाहता है यू आर आई एम नॉट अ रोबोट लिखा हुआ था उसमें, यू आर अ ह्यूमन बींग। सो ह्यूमन बींग क्या करता है, पैटर्न्स को बड़े आराम से समझ सकता है, तो दैट कैन हेल्प द फर्म, दैट कैन हेल्प द कंप्यूटर और दैट वेबसाइट टू अंडरस्टैंड वेदर द एंट्री और अटेम्प्ट एंट्री अटेम्प्ट इज जेन्यून इनफ एंड इट्स नॉट बींग एंटर्ड बाय सम यू नो सम कंप्यूटर, बिकॉज आप प्रोग्राम करके हैकिंग भी कर सकते हो। सो जो दूसरे एंड पे अटेम्प्ट कर रहा है लॉगिन करने का, वो एक ह्यूमन बींग ही है। सो आप फ्रॉड्स रोक सकते हो, कस्टमर की जेन्युइनिटी आइडेंटिफाई कर सकते हो, एंड यू कैन चर्न योर प्रोसेसेस आल्सो। मशीन लर्निंग कैन हेल्प यू टू चर्न योर प्रोसेसेस, चर्न योर प्रोडक्ट्स राइट। सो लाइक आई हैव सेड दैट बेस्ड ऑन द फीडबैक दैट यू हैव गेव टू गूगल मैप राइट, दे कैन इम्प्रूव देयर वर्जन्स, दे विल कम आउट विद अ न्यू वर्जन ऑफ देयर एप्स। दिस इज लर्निंग ऑल अबाउट मशीन लर्निंग। व्हेन इट कम्स टू ML क्लासिफिकेशन, वी हैव फोर यू नो वेज इट वर्क्स, एंड इट इज नथिंग बट द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन डिपेंडेंट एंड इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल राइट। एनीथिंग विच इज हैपनिंग इन द वर्ल्ड हैज टू कंपोनेंट्स, वन इज कॉल्ड इंडिपेंडेंट एंड सेकेंड इज डिपेंडेंट राइट। सो फॉर एग्जाम्पल योर लर्निंग फ्रॉम दिस क्लास इज डिपेंड अपॉन हाउ मच एफर्ट्स योर टीचर इज पुटिंग प्लस हाउ मच एफर्ट्स यू आर पुटिंग इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड हिज एफर्ट्स। सो द लर्निंग ऑफ एनी क्लास इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन टू वेरिएबल्स। इफ द लर्निंग इज वाई, कैपिटल वाई, सो इट डिपेंड्स ऑन टू वेरिएबल्स विच आर इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स राइट। वन इज एक्स वन एंड सेकेंड इज एक्स टू। एक्स वन इज द एफर्ट्स दैट अ टीचर इज पुटिंग टू मेक हिज लेक्चर मोर इंटरेक्टिव, मोर अंडरस्टैंडेबल, एंड एक्स टू इज द एफर्ट दैट द स्टूडेंट इज पुटिंग इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड द लेक्चर मोर इंटरेक्टिवली एंड टू मेक इट मोर अंडरस्टैंडिंग टू अंडरस्टूड टू हर और हिम। सो वाई इज अ लर्निंग ऑफ अ क्लास एंड इट इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन टू वेरिएबल एक्स वन एंड एक्स टू। नाउ इम्पॉर्टेंटली कंसिडरिंग दिस एज अ बेस, आई विश टू टेल यू दैट मशीन लर्निंग वाइल यू डू पाइथन, यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस एज अ बेसिक दैट इट कैन बी हैपन इन four form. It has based on, you know, machine learning can be classified into four forms, four form of algorithms. One is called supervised algorithm. Second is unsupervised. Third is reinforced learning. And fourth is evolution learning. So now let us talk about the supervised learning first. So now, अगर आपको ये पता है कि इंडिपेंडेंट कौन है डिपेंडेंट कौन है तो आपका काम इजी हो जाएगा. ऐसी लर्निंग को आप सुपरवाइज करोगे एज अ राइटर, एज अ प्रोग्रामर, एज अ पाइथन कोड राइटर. जब आपको पता है कि लर्निंग एक्स वन और एक्स टू पर डिपेंड करती है, कि अगर स्टूडेंट ठीक से पार्टिसिपेट नहीं कर रहे हैं, या स्टूडेंट का बैकग्राउंड नहीं है, या स्टूडेंट की अंडरस्टैंडिंग नहीं है, या उसका आई क्यू नहीं है, उसका डिटर्मिनेशन नहीं है, उसका एटीट्यूड नहीं है, उसको लॉन्ग सेटिंग में बैठने की आदत नहीं है, उसको ऑनलाइन लेक्चरिंग की आदत नहीं है, तो एक्स टू वीक होने की वजह से वाई पे इफेक्ट पड़ेगा. सिमिलरली अगर एक्स वन वीक है, जो कि अपने आप में एक इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल है, टीचर एफिशिएंट नहीं है, टीचर कम्युनिकेट नहीं कर पा रहा है, टीचर का लिंगुअल इश्यू है कुछ, वो मलयाली बोलता है, उसको अंग्रेजी या हिंदी बोलनी नहीं आती है, या कोई दूसरी रीजनल लैंग्वेज बोलता है, टीचर का सब्जेक्ट की नॉलेज नहीं है, टीचर इनएक्सपीरियंस्ड है, टीचर को क्वेरीज डील करनी नहीं आती, लॉट ऑफ फैक्टर्स. अगर एक्स वन वीक है तब भी वाई पे इफेक्ट पड़ेगा, और अगर दोनों ही चीज़ें वीक हैं तो वाई की कंडीशन और वीक हो जाएगी. आर यू एबल टू मेक सम सेंस आउट ऑफ इट? कैन यू मेक सेंस आउट ऑफ इट? ओके, सो हियर वी आर अवेयर दैट बोथ डिपेंडेंट एंड इंडिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल्स वॉट दे आर एंड वॉट इज द डिग्री ऑफ इफेक्ट दे हैव कलेक्टिवली एंड इंडिविजुअली ऑन आउटपुट. This is called as supervised learning, right? Where we can supervise x, y, and x1 and x2 and y, right? So this form of learning is called supervised learning. जैसे linear regression होता है, आपको पता है कि COVID patient बढ़ जाएंगे, y बढ़ जाएंगे, अगर लोग x1 यानी कि precautions नहीं रखेंगे, x2 यानी government उस पर कोई lockdown situation नहीं रखेगी. तो ये कॉम्बिनेशन किसी भी फॉर्म में आप समझ सकते हैं कि वाई यानी इन्फेक्शन बढ़ सकता है लोगों में, अगर लोग रिलेक्टेंट होंगे एक्स वन, वो सोशल नॉर्म्स को, सोशल डिस्टेंसिंग नॉर्म्स को फुलफिल नहीं करेंगे, ये सब एक्स वन के अंदर आ गया. एक्स टू के अंदर ये आ गया कि गवर्नमेंट उसको एनफोर्स नहीं कर पाएगी, गवर्नमेंट कहेगी कि हम लॉकडाउन नहीं करेंगे जैसे पाकिस्तान में हुआ. तो ये सारे सिचुएशंस क्या हैं, अल्टीमेटली वाई को इन्फ्लुएंस करते हैं एडवर्सली, ऑब्वियसली. इससे आपके पेशेंट्स बढ़ जाते हैं बिकॉज ट्रांसमिशन बढ़ रहा है. इसके अलावा लॉजिस्टिक रिग्रेशन या फिर डिटर्मिनिस्टिक एनालिसिस, ये सारी चीज़ें आती हैं आपकी सुपरवाइज्ड लर्निंग एल्गोरिथम के अंदर. दूसरी फॉर्म है अनसुपरवाइज्ड, यहाँ पे आपको आउटपुट वेरिएबल नहीं पता है क्या आएगा, यू आर नॉट अवेयर अबाउट. यहाँ पे तो पता था ट्रांसमिशन इन्फेक्शन बढ़ जाएगा वाई की केस में, या हमारी क्लासरूम डिजास्टर हो जाएगी अगर एक्स वन और एक्स टू में गड़बड़ होगी, तो हमें आउटपुट पता है. पर अनसुपरवाइज लर्निंग एल्गोरिथम एज द नेम सजेस्टेड, यहाँ पर आपको आउटपुट नहीं पता है, वैल्यू ऑफ आउटपुट आर इज अननोन टू यू, राइट. जैसे आप क्लस्टरिंग करते हो या प्रिंसिपल कंपोनेंट एनालिसिस करते हो, वहां पर अनसुपरवाइज लर्निंग रहती है. अभी क्या चीज़ है ये क्लस्टरिंग क्या होती है या प्रिंसिपल कंपोनेंट एनालिसिस क्या होता है? नाउ फॉर एग्जांपल, मैं टर्म यूज करूंगा ट्रेनिंग डेटा, उसको बाद में मैं समझाऊंगा. फिलहाल अभी मैं बताता हूं आपको कि सपोज यू आर नॉट अवेयर अबाउट कि कोविड 19 ड्रग या वैक्सीन लगने के बाद ह्यूमन बॉडी कैसे रिएक्ट करती है, बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट ने ह्यूमन ट्रायल्स के लिए मना कर दिया सपोज, तो ह्यूमन बॉडी कैसे रिएक्ट करती है ये आपको नहीं पता है. इसलिए वैक्सीन डायरेक्टली आती है, उसको परमिशन मिल जाती है, सपोज ये क्लॉज हट गया है कि उसमें ह्यूमन ट्रायल्स होने चाहिए, सो डायरेक्टली मशीन वैक्सीन मार्केट में आती है और बॉडी में इन्फ्यूज की जाती है. कुछ वॉलंटियर्स मिल जाते हैं आपको एनजीओ के जिनकी बॉडी पे इन्फ्यूज किया गया. यू आर नॉट अवेयर अबाउट हाउ बॉडी रिएक्ट्स टू द वैक्सीन. ये सिचुएशन अपने आप में अनसुपरवाइज्ड लर्निंग की है, where you not aware about the possible outcome, possible, you know, value. This is called as unsupervised learning. For example, आपने पैसा जुए में लगाया एंड यू आर नॉट अवेयर कि पैसा प्रॉफिट देगा या लॉस होगा, तो वो अनसुपरवाइज लर्निंग कहलाएगी, राइट? सो कोई भी गैमलिंग जो आप देख रहे होंगे आजकल, ऑनलाइन गैमलिंग चल रही है, ऑनलाइन KPL, IPL, GPL, PPL चलते हैं, वॉट इज दैट? आप जुआ खेलने नहीं जाते हो पर आप बेटिंग कर रहे हो, जुआ ही बोलूंगा मैं उसको रफ वर्ड्स में, आप किसी टीम पे पैसा लगाते हो, अल्टीमेटली वो टीम जीतती है नहीं जीतती है उसके परफॉर्मेंस पे डिपेंड करता है, पर आउटपुट आपको अभी भी नहीं पता है। ऐसी सो कॉल्ड एल्गोरिथम जिसके बेस पे वो सॉफ्टवेयर वर्क कर रहा है, सॉफ्टवेयर को खुद भी नहीं पता है कि आउटपुट क्या आने वाला है, इट इज नॉट प्री डिसाइडेड, राइट? दिस इज कॉल्ड एज अनसुपरवाइज्ड लर्निंग। थर्ड फॉर्म ऑफ लर्निंग इज रीएनफोर्समेंट लर्निंग, राइट? जैसे आपने, बहुत सिंपल सा मैं एग्जांपल लेता हूँ, ये आपको बहुत आराम से समझ में आएगा। राशि थापा ने अपना, उसको आर्टिकल लिखने का शौक था, आर्टिकल वो हैंड रिटन नहीं लिखती थी क्योंकि नई एज की राइटर है, तो राशि थापा एमएस वर्ड का इस्तेमाल करती है। तो राशि थापा ने अगर एमएस वर्ड में टाइपिंग करी और एक वर्ड टाइप किया ब्यूटीफुल, राशि ब्यूटीफुल की स्पेलिंग बताओ।
I-F-U-L.
Okay, suppose you by any chance beautiful की spelling आपने लिख दी B-U-U-T-I-F-U-L, beautiful, B-U-U, B-U-U-T-I-F-U-L, और आपने enter press किया और आगे बढ़ गया, तो राशि क्या होता है इसके बाद? MS Word processor में क्या होता है?
Error आ जाता है, red color का वो आता है।
Exactly, और आप उसके बाद क्या करते हो?
तो फिर ऑटो करेक्ट में स्पेलिंग, राइट स्पेलिंग भी आ जाती है, तो वो क्लिक कर करेक्ट हो जाता है।
ओके, नाउ राइट स्पेलिंग में एक तो ब्यूटीफुल की स्पेलिंग आएगी जो अभी आपने बोली, बी ई ए यू टी आई एफ यू एल, और सिमिलर वर्ड्स आ जाएंगे,
यस सर,
राइट? उसमें ड्यूटीफुल भी आएगा एक वर्ड, एक वर्ड आएगा बॉन्टीफुल, बी ओ यू एन टी आई एफ यू एल, एंड डी यू टी आई एफ यू एल। सो एक्चुअली वर्ड प्रोसेसर ये समझने लग जाता है, वर्ड प्रोसेसर ये समझने लग जाता है कि आप स्पेल चेक सॉफ्टवेयर, आई मीन टू से वर्ड प्रोसेसर यहाँ पे एम एस वर्ड में स्पेल चेक सॉफ्टवेयर इन बिल्ड है, वो आपको पॉसिबल एरर्स बता के री एनफोर्स करता है, मजबूर करता है कि आप किसी करेक्ट ऑप्शन पे जाएं। आपकी समझ से सेंटेंस कुछ भी बन रहा हो, उसकी समझ से सेंटेंस में करेक्ट ग्रामर होनी, करेक्ट सो कॉल्ड वर्ड होना चाहिए। तो ये एक रीएनफोर्स लर्निंग का रिजल्ट है कि किसी भी प्रकार की अनसर्टेनिटी इनपुट या आउटपुट वेरिएबल में आने पे मशीन उसे करेक्ट करती है, और जो ये सॉफ्टवेयर्स हैं, स्पेल चेक सॉफ्टवेयर कुड बी एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ रीएनफोर्स लर्निंग। आई थिंक दिस इज वेरी क्लियर टू यू, ताकि सेंटेंस क्लियर बन सके, ग्रामेटिकली करेक्ट हो, उसकी स्पेलिंग करेक्ट हो, ये इंश्योर करता है आपका एमएस वर्ड का स्पेल चेक सॉफ्टवेयर। फोर्थ इज एवोल्यूशन लर्निंग। एवोल्यूशन लर्निंग बहुत सिंपल है, आप किसी प्रॉब्लम का सॉल्यूशन देने के लिए अपने आप को इवॉल्व करते हो, राइट? इसमें कई सारी एल्गोरिथम्स हैं, जैसे जेनेटिक एल्गोरिथम है या एंट कलोनी एल्गोरिथम है, एंट कलोनी एल्गोरिथम है, पर मैं आपको उससे इस भाषा में समझा देता हूँ कि ओके, सपोज मेरी जगह आपको कोई रोबोट पढ़ा रहा है, कोई मशीन पढ़ा रही, और मशीन की जो प्रोग्रामिंग है, मशीन पाइथन पढ़ा रही है कोई मशीन, अभी ऐसा टाइम भी आएगा, और मशीन जब उन स्टूडेंट्स को पढ़ाती है जो टेक्निकल बैकग्राउंड के स्टूडेंट्स हैं, तब वो अलग एग्जांपल्स लेके पढ़ाती हैं, जब नॉन टेक्निकल एग्जांपल्स, नॉन टेक्नोलॉजिकल बैकग्राउंड के स्टूडेंट होते हैं, तो उसी सब्जेक्ट को पढ़ाने के लिए अलग एग्जांपल लेती हैं। सो मशीन अपने आप को इवॉल्व कर रही है, बिकॉज यहाँ पर जो रेसिपिएंट एंड पे हैं, जो उसको रिसीव कर रहे हैं, उसकी प्रॉब्लम की डिफ़िकल्टी लेवल, समझने की डिफ़िकल्टी, समझने का लेवल डिफरेंट है। जैसे मैं अभी अपने ही लेक्चर की बात करूं, जब मैं मशीन लर्निंग MBA 2 years के, जब मैं बिजनेस एनालिटिक्स MBA 2 years के स्टूडेंट्स को बताऊंगा, तो वहां व्यू पॉइंट डिफरेंट होगा, पढ़ाने का स्टाइल भी डिफरेंट होगा, राइट एग्जाम्पल्स ऐसे होंगे जो बहुत प्राइमरी लेवल के एग्जाम्पल्स होंगे, बिकॉज कंसिडरिंग द फैक्ट कि इंडस्ट स्टूडेंट ग्रेजुएशन के बाद इंडस्ट्री में नहीं गया है, उसको नहीं पता है कुछ इंडस्ट्री में कैसे काम होता है. एग्जाम्पल्स बहुत रूटीन लाइफ के होंगे, नॉन बिजनेस एग्जाम्पल्स होंगे या नॉन प्रैक्टिकल एग्जाम्पल्स होंगे. वेयर एज अगर कोर्स EMBA स्टूडेंट्स को पढ़ाया जाएगा जिनका बैकग्राउंड कम से कम 10 साल का है, ग्रेजुएशन के बाद वो 10 साल या 8 साल इंडस्ट्री में रहे हुए हैं, तो वहाँ एग्जाम्पल्स अलग कोट किए जाएंगे. सो डिपेंड्स ऑन द काइंड ऑफ यू नो कस्टमर दैट अ टीचर और अ लेक्चरर इज कैटरिंग. बेस्ड ऑन दैट द वे ऑफ प्रेजेंटेशन विल गेट चेंज, बिकॉज आउटपुट इनपुट को चेंज कर रहे हैं. यहाँ पे वाई एक्स को इन्फ्लुएंस कर रहे हैं, आपको वाई पता है कि किसको कैटर करना है, और अकॉर्डिंगली आप अपने लेक्चर्स का पैटर्न एग्जाम्पल सेटिंग्स चेंज कर रहे हैं. राइट, सो दिस इज समथिंग वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड. नाउ उसके बाद पाइथन है डायरेक्टली, एंड पाइथन में नॉर्मली अगर आप पाइथन लर्न करना चाहते हैं तो सबसे पहले जो एलिमेंट्री चीज़ है मशीन लर्निंग के लिए, आपको पाइथन चाहिए. पाइथन चारों तरफ के एल्गोरिथम्स आप अगर यूज़ करना चाहते हो तो पाइथन कुड बी अ पॉसिबल वे टू डू इट. बिकॉज होता क्या है कि ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जो है ना, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अपने परफॉर्मेंस को मेजर करने के लिए कुछ KPIs बनाती है. ओके, जो स्टूडेंट्स बिल्कुल नए हैं इस बात को समझने के लिए, उनको समझाने के लिए सुभाष भट्टी बताएंगे कि KPIs क्या होती हैं. ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अपने परफॉर्मेंस को मेजर करने के लिए KPI बनाती है. इस सेंटेंस को थोड़ा रिवाइव
की
कीजिए,
परफॉर्मिंग इंडिकेटर्स होते हैं सर,
क्या होते हैं, क्या ऑब्जेक्टिव होते हैं उनके.
सो मींस लाइक मींस सेट ऑफ पैरामीटर्स होते हैं जो हम कस्टमर के साथ डील करते हैं कि वी विल परफॉर्म ऑन दीज पैरामीटर्स ऑब्जेक्टिव्स काइंड ऑफ थिंग.
ओके, सो या ही इज राइट. ऑर्गेनाइजेशन अपने परफॉर्मेंस को कस्टमर व्यू, आपकी सक्सेस और आपकी विफलता इस बात पे डिपेंड करती है कि कस्टमर इसे परसीव कर रहा है. सो नाउ वी हैव अ सेट ऑफ KPIs. कस्टमर का मतलब हमेशा कंज्यूमर नहीं है, कस्टमर का मतलब आपके सप्लायर्स भी हो सकते हैं, जिनको आप प्रोडक्ट क्लाइंट भी हो सकते हैं. सो किसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के KPIs उसके सक्सेस और फेलियर को इन्फ्लुएंस करते हैं ऑफ कोर्स, और KPI के बेस पे ही ऑर्गेनाइजेशन डिसीजन लेती है. एक दो कस्टमर्स हो तो काम चल जाएगा. कस्टमर्स आपके उतने हो जितने अमेजन के हैं, ट्विटर के हैं, फेसबुक के हैं, राइट, तब कॉम्प्लिकेशन बढ़ जाती है, बिकॉज हर कस्टमर की रिक्वायरमेंट डिफरेंट है. राइट, जब आप अमेजन से शॉपिंग करते हो तो हो सकता है आप कुछ और, आप अभी जैसे सेमवाल सेमवाल साहब के बच्चा रो रहा था तो उसको उनको डायपर्स चाहिए बच्चे के लिए. ये स्थिति पंकज बिष्ट के साथ नहीं है, पंकज बिष्ट अभी अनमेरिड है. राइट, तो उनको डायपर नहीं चाहिए, उनको तो जैकेट्स खरीदनी है ऑनलाइन. राशि थापा इज अ यंग गर्ल, शी डोंट केयर अबाउट डायपर्स एंड जैकेट्स, शी वॉन्ट टू परचेज पर्स फॉर हर सेल्फ फ्रॉम अमेजन. उदित रोहिल्या की रिक्वायरमेंट डिफरेंट है. सो वी हैव डिफरेंट कस्टमर्स, बट बाय एंड लार्ज Amazon has created some KPIs which is broadly catering the need of each and every customer, whether it is Rashi Thapa kind of, Pankaj Pish type of, Devi Prasad type of, or anybody else. So, इतने diversified customers के requirements समझने के लिए we have to create a kind of, you know, interface, of course. But for understanding the input from the interface, we also need to understand which algorithm is fit for that. Whether it is coming all the way from one form, two form, three form, or four form, right? That I've discussed just before. So, ऐसे में मशीन लर्निंग आपको हेल्प करेगी. और एक पॉसिबल फॉर्म ऑफ स्टेप्स रहेगा, एक फ्रेमवर्क बना रहता है जिसको फॉलो किया जाता है कि हम सबसे पहले डेटा कलेक्शन करेंगे, सबसे पहले जो समझेंगे हमें करना क्या है, हमारा KPI क्या है, हम आउटपुट क्या जनरेट करना चाहते हैं. इज इट कस्टमर सेटिस्फेक्शन, इट इज रेवेन्यू जनरेशन, इट इज कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ बोथ, और इट इज समथिंग यू नो डिफरेंट. सबसे पहले हमें समझना पड़ेगा कि हमारी अपॉर्चुनिटीज क्या क्या हैं, क्या क्या प्रॉब्लम हमें ध्यान में रखनी है. प्रॉब्लम का मतलब यहाँ पे आपका उद्देश्य क्या है, एंड अकॉर्डिंगली आप डेटा कलेक्ट करोगे. जैसे राशि थापा को बेस्ट पर्स देना है, उसकी इकोनॉमी या उसके पास परचेस के बेस पे। तो ऑब्वियसली उसमें प्रिडिक्टिव एनालिटिक्स लगेगा, बट ये समझना ज़रूरी है कि वो आया कैसे। सो मशीन को यानी अमेजन को ही समझना पड़ेगा कि अल्टीमेटली जो हम इंटरफेस डेवलप कर रहे हैं राशि थापा के लिए वो कैसे अब रिजल्ट देगा। सो देर आर लॉट ऑफ वेज एंड मीन्स टू डू इट राइट। सो ये मैं किसी एक एडिशनल क्लास में नेक्स्ट वीक हम लेंगे, अभी जो आने वाला टाइम है, एंड आई विल लेट यू नो हाउ इट वर्क। ठीक है, सो अभी मैं थक गया हूँ, 9 बज गए, मेरे को इस्कॉन जाना है और तैयार होना है उसके लिए। तो अभी के लिए इतना ही, और अगर आपको कुछ पूछना है अभी के डिस्कशन से यू कैन यू नो वेरी वेल आस्क, पूछिए। इफ यू हैव सम क्वेरी यू कैन आस्क। अभी पाइथन हमने कोडिंग शुरू नहीं करी है, सो एनीथिंग यू लाइक टू आस्क यू कैन आस्क। इज इट क्लियर टू एवरीबडी दैट व्हाई डू
यस
वी
सर।
रिक्वायर। दादा जी कुछ पूछना चाहती हैं?
नहीं नहीं सर, थैंक यू सर। बस ये रिकॉर्डिंग आप फॉरवर्ड कर देना।
हाँ, रिकॉर्डिंग में मैं
थैंक
बंद कर
यू
देता हूँ पहले, जैसे मैं कर दूंगा
थैंक
आपको।
यू।